But first, the progressive media love to push racial division at every opportunity. Joe Biden loves to push racial division at every opportunity. So that's the Democrats and the progressive media, but I repeat myself. Anyway, every now and then someone pops up to put the race baiters back in their place. So I had to admire head coach of the Boston Celtics, Joe Mazzulla, for the way he handled a reporter's question at a press conference yesterday. Now, the Celtics are currently battling the Dallas Mavericks in the NBA Finals. And a reporter from Yahoo Sports asked if Mazzulla thought it was significant that both head coaches were black, given the plight of black coaches. Have a listen to what happened.
For the first time since 1975, this is the NBA Finals where you have two black head coaches. Given the plight sometimes of black head coaches in the NBA, do you think this is a significant moment? Do you take pride in this? How do you view this, or do you not see it at all?
I wonder how many of those have been Christian coaches.
Well, judging by the silence, it's fair to say that Mazzulla's response wasn't exactly what the media was looking for. Rather than worry about the plight of black men in the NBA, where more than 70% of players are African-American, we should be more worried about the plight of intelligent journalists, since they seem to be in short supply. Mazzulla's response was so good that it completely stumped not just the Yahoo Sports journalists, but everyone else in the room. First, why ask about black coaches and not Christian coaches, or left-handed coaches, or vegan coaches, or what about Christian left-handed vegan coaches who drive electric vehicles? Mazzulla's response highlighted the inanity of continually assessing people according to characteristics that literally have nothing to do with what they're doing. I seem to remember someone talking about that one time.
I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character.
Second, Mazzulla highlighted the way to overcome division, and that's by looking up for your identity, which tends to produce humility, rather than looking within, which, as we now see everywhere in our culture, only leads to narcissism. If the Declaration of Independence is true, that all men are created by God, well, then everything else is semantics, and identity politics is exposed for what it really is, a shameless, manipulative ploy by people interested only in power. Now, yesterday wasn't the first time Mazzulla has left the progressive press pack speechless. Back in 2022, he was asked if he'd met with Prince William and Princess Kate during their trip to America. Have a listen to that exchange.
A non-basketball question. Did you get a chance to meet with the royal family? And if not, how was it like having them there in the building?
Jesus, Mary, and Joseph?
The Prince and Princess of Wales.
Oh, no, I did not. I'm only familiar with one royal family. I don't know too much about that one.
Once again, he silences the room. Now, he wasn't being disrespectful to the Prince and Princess of Wales, but he was gently reminding the press pack that our culture's obsession with celebrity, well, it's like chasing a mist. If we're all created in the image of God, then even kings and queens and presidents all stand on equal footing. No one is more deserving than anyone else, and everyone is just as in need of grace and forgiveness as everyone else. The awkward silence in the room demonstrated how far we've moved from these simple truths and how quickly the progressive narrative of division and discord dissolves in the face of such simple truths. I'm pretty sure that's what they call in basketball a slam dunk.